everyone. Which what we call placenta accreta, percreta, all these abnormal placenta. You see, the gap is very short. When you have no space, because now the gap is so little. The gap, this is the gap, and the normal part of the uterus is so thin now. When the pregnancy and the placenta ends up there, you must understand placenta wants to look for nourishment, right? They want to look for oxygen, nutrient. They want to look for all these things. And when they want to look for all these things, all the place that is so thin and they cannot get the nutrient, they're going to be exactly like a cactus tree. You know a cactus tree? So when you have a cactus tree, when he cannot find water, he'll just grow a lot of roots, right? A lot of roots go deep inside to find the water, right? So same, our placenta, when it cannot get enough nutrient, it will grow roots all the way in, into the bladder, the bowel, everywhere to find nutrient. So that's why you have those placenta that cannot remove. And placenta accreta is when placenta, those we call abnormal placenta, like accreta, percreta, increta, the three names, depends on how deep the placenta has gone. It's all because it is on a Caesar scar that is not giving enough nutrient. You see, you have a gap. So this whole spectrum, whether your pregnancy will end up with a scar rupture, or whether it won't rupture, it will still go on throughout 9 months, but only thing you'll get this abnormal placenta, or you can still have a healthy placenta and healthy pregnancy. All depends on, number one, the gap and how deep the gap. If it's more than 50%, the risk is high. Less than 50% of the entire thickness, the risk is not so high. There are multiple things you can do. Sometimes you say, if it's not disturbing you, you can don't want to do anything. Let's say, because you get pregnant, not necessarily your pregnancy has to stick at where the gap is, right? It can be very good pregnancy, go high up in the uterus. Okay, it can. So it not necessarily can happen. So if it's not disturbing you, and you can still get pregnant, and it doesn't give you pain or this spotting that you get every month, you can leave it alone. Because it is a gap, but you still have a very healthy uterus. But when it gives you problem, let's say it gives you problem because you cannot get pregnant, you keep bleeding every month, you have this pain every month when your menses come, or every other day, then of course we need to treat. The gap is more than 50% of the thickness, so we do worry about scar rupture. Then we can actually do a formal repair. Yeah, we need to still operate on you, but it is usually done either laparoscopic or robotic. So we either do laparoscopic with just 3 holes on your tummy. We go in, we find the gap, we clear the gap, we stitch back. Because most likely it's a wound that is open up, either due to when the stitching, the stitch didn't complete stitching, or your wound itself didn't heal well. So this time we will clear up, get all the healthy tissues to come in, then only we stitch back, okay? But scar rupture can be something that we are very worried, and if you want to try natural birth and you worry about scar rupture, if you see your scar, the gap is so big and the lining is so thin, more, or maybe already, maybe your gap is like more than 70-80%, if you don't want to take the risk, it may be good to repair it before you're pregnant again. Of course, those who cannot get pregnant, if you have a gap, you want to get pregnant, you need to do the surgery. Not necessarily you can need to repair. Of course, a repair is always better than just clearing. But clearing is a simple surgery. It's better than not doing anything. Last of all, for all those who don't plan to be pregnant anymore, if it's not disturbing you, just let it be. If it's disturbing you, then you either go on long-term birth control pill, or you just do this simple surgery and just clear it off lah. So please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.